All right, guys, so we learned about Boolean operators, strings, integers, etc. We learned how to redefine variables. What we're going to be learning about in this video is how to compare values. So the most basic way to compare two values is to check if something is true. And that's what we're doing, essentially. We're checking if something is true or false. It's called a truth checking, I guess. And what we're going to be doing first is checking what we've done is we've checked if something equals something else. And again, you can say, does true equal true? And it's going to say true. Or we can say, does high equal high? It's going to return true. But if we say high equals 3, it returns false because it is not the same. So use two equal signs to compare values and use one equal sign to assign values. So if I said high equals 3, it's going to freak out because it doesn't know what I'm doing there. A string never goes on the left of something. Or an integer. You couldn't do 5 equals 6. An invalid left-hand side in assignment. So basically, it knows we're assigning a value to something because we're using the equal sign. We have a value there for it, but we can't assign that to an integer. We can assign it to a variable. And so if we create a variable called myNum, we can set it to 6. Now every time we print out myNum, it's going to use 6. So here we could say, is myNum equal to 6? And that's the most common reason you'll find fact-checking or truth-checking is to see if a variable is equal to something. So let's say that I have started a website that can let people sign up. And if they choose to, they can purchase a premium service or a subscription. So I'm going to create a variable. Let's assume that I'm a user right now, and my variable is set to is premium user, and I'm not. So let's say we only want to provide a bit of code, or we want to do something special if the person is a premium user. So we would say, we would compare that is premium user. And is that equal to true? And if it is, we can do something, but it's not, so we're not going to do anything. And that brings us into if statements. If statements are basically a way to apply this and do something based on the result, whatever we want to. But we're not quite done with comparisons. We can also compare if something is not equal to something else. So if is premium user is not equal to true, then maybe we'll say, hey, you should buy this, you know, or you should subscribe as a premium user. So the operators to use when comparing if something is not equal to another one is to use an exclamation point followed by an equal sign. And these operators right here means is not equal to. Basically in programming, not just in JavaScript, but in PHP and other languages, the exclamation sign means not. So by combining it here, it's saying not equal, basically. You can also compare greater than or less than. So we can say, is 5 less than 7? And it is true. Now we can also say, is 7 less than 7? It's going to say false. But if I said, is 7 greater than 7? It also says false. So maybe we want to run a bit of code, and I'll show you guys examples as soon as we get into if statements, but maybe we want to compare if a number is greater than or equal to a number. So we would say, is 7 greater than equal sign 7? And it's going to return true because 7 is equal to 7. It's not greater than. You can do the same with less than. 7 is less than or equal to 7. And that's going to return true as well. So with all that said, let's start writing if statements. And for if statements, we are going to move back to our IDE, and we're going to be running this page every time we want to update it.